G'day everyone, how you going today? I will just do a follow-up video on our Synology NAS network access storage device, or network storage device NAS. So in this video I'll show you how to create a stop shortcut with the Synology NAS. So we're running the 918 plus, which is 32 terabyte, and in this video I'll show you how to create a shortcut to desktop shortcut to be able to access your NAS. So it's going through the Synology web browser to log in, to extract videos or upload. So this is a quicker way that I found. So what we'll do in, I'll just reduce that, in Windows File Explorer, open that up so we can see it, in Windows File Explorer or this PC, just open your desktop. So this is File Explorer. So what you do, you type in your your IP address, your system, double backslashes, your IP address, your server, and this is mine, and you press enter. So a screen will come up, login credentials, and as I'm an administrator, I have full access, but so you'll only be shown what access you have to what company or personal server you have. So I'll just type in my details. Password. Press OK. Password's wrong. Try again. It's always good to have a good strong password, because you don't want people trying to break in or trying to access some sort of system all over the world. It's happening every day. So here you go, this is my server. This is all my folders, files and everything. And now I have a list of folders that are displayed, and in this you'll only be given access to the folders you have permission to access to. Say I want our YouTube videos to be accessed on this laptop, which is a secondary system. So I want to access all my YouTube videos, which are all these. So what I'll do, click your folder you want to create a shortcut to, and create shortcut. And you'll be prompted, Windows can't create a shortcut here. Would you like the shortcut to be placed on your desktop instead? Yes. So if I go back into my desktop, just reset, here we go. Full access to all their videos without logging all the time. Alright, so now what we can do, and also you can actually map your drive. If you right click it, map drive network, you allocated a name, a letter, a name, so I'll say A, reconnect and sign in. Or you can have actually connect using different credentials. So what I'll do, finish this, I'll just get out of this, then my PC, open it up, and actually see I've got a network drive linked straight to my Synology NAS, which allows me to access videos, download it and do whatever. This is far easier than the original method of, so originally what you had to do was log in through the web browser. Previously, this is how we used to log in, and this is good for, this is more of an admin role, check up, see how your station is, your health, who's logged in, control panel. Face center, alright, so let's log out of that. So anyway, so this is a quick tutorial on how to access your, how to create a shortcut on your desktop, Windows desktop, so you can actually mess straight away. So it's going into the web, original web browser that Synology has, which is fabulous. I'll just find a pain. Yeah, I want to pull out videos, edit, and logging in or automatic logging in. I'll just find this method far easier. So now I can pull out whatever videos I like. And so hope you like this video, and I'll do another review on how our Synology is performing. So far we've had it for 4 weeks and marvellous, and we've already got a bit over 1 terabyte on the system. So the good thing about NAS is I can plug any computer, or actually I can log into any computer as long as you have your login credentials. You can log in into my NAS from anywhere in the world. At this moment we have a person from, actually 2 people from the Philippines, for example. They got their own login credentials, so what they do, they log into our NAS, upload videos and straight into our NAS, and the videos are here within minutes, and I allocate and put them in which folders I want, and far better. Previously, videos were sent through Facebook, and it's always 760p, not 1080. And yeah, very bad for trying to edit a 4K video. So anyway, hope you like this. Stay tuned for some more. Thanks.